My research program has been heavily influenced by biology, the way in which natural systems construct molecules. Photosynthesis is the way in which plants have evolved very complex systems to harness light in the form of photons and convert it into chemical energy. And so in 2015, we set ourselves the target of trying to emulate that process for the function of manipulating alkene geometry. So alkenes are small two-carbon units that are the building blocks of a variety of medicines and essential vitamins. And you'll notice that this alkene, this C2 carbon unit, has two substituents. And these two substituents can exist in two geometric forms. In one case, they're opposite to each other, and in this case, they're on the same face. It's very easy to convert this isomer to this isomer, but the opposite is somewhat challenging because one has to introduce energy into the system. So inspired by photosynthesis, we wondered if it might be possible to develop a small molecule antenna to achieve that reaction. And the answer came in the form of another essential vitamin, riboflavin, which we find in fruits and cereals and all over. Riboflavin is an excellent light harvester, and it is able to harvest light, convert it into energy, transfer it to low-lying species such like this, and drive reactions uphill. And this process is really important in biology because this 1-0 switch of alkenes is exactly what underpins our visual cycle. And this is an example here. This is retinol. This is the molecule responsible for mammalian vision. And you can see here in the middle, there's an alkene with two substituents. And it's really the 1-0 switch of that small molecule that is responsible for mammalian visual. So it's a very fascinating process. And using this, we've been able to develop methods that harvest photons in a very sustainable way and use them to drive reactions uphill in a way that would be traditionally difficult.
Every time molecules are interacting together, in order to perform the chemical reaction, there is a certain amount of energy necessary to overcome the activational barrier. In typical processes, this is done by heating the reaction, but there are other options. One of them is energy transfer, where you actually utilize the energy of light. In this case, your chemical reaction also contains a photocatalyst. This is a typically organic dye which absorbs the light and can transfer its energy to the substrate in order to do the reaction. This has the advantage that not only the reaction conditions are milder, but also allows us to do reactions which wouldn't otherwise be possible at all.
Viele chemische Produktionsprozesse sind thermodynamisch gesteuert. Das heißt, dass das Produktverhältnis und die Selektivität des chemischen Prozesses durch den Energieeintrag gesteuert wird. Durch die Verwendung von Licht und der Methodik, die von Rhein und seiner Gruppe entwickelt worden ist, haben wir die Möglichkeit, die Reaktion wesentlich selektiver zu machen und ein Produkt spezifisch herzustellen.
I know Ryan since 2013, when he was recruited as a SIM professor for chemical biology, and this is really what his research is about. So he developed novel strategies, novel chemical syntheses to design ligands, for example, for biologically active molecules. And on the other hand, he used biological principles in his chemical syntheses. So that made him and has made him very special as a scientist.
Für unseren Forschungsverbund, zum Beispiel auch hier im Multiscale Imaging Center, ist das Fach, was Ryan Gilmer vertritt, die chemische Biologie sehr wichtig, weil man versucht, mit chemischen Substanzen biologische Systeme, Organismen zu beeinflussen. Ein Beispiel hier wäre für die Bildgebung, wenn man radioaktive Zucker hätte, die nur von Bakterien gefressen werden, das ist etwas, woran Ryan Gilmer zusammen mit anderen Wissenschaftlern hier arbeitet, dann könnte man diese radioaktiv markieren und im Körper verfolgen. Das heißt, wir sehen auf einmal Bakterien im Menschen oder auch im Modellorganismus leuchten.
Unter molekularem Design verstehen wir bei uns in der Gruppe, dass wir uns Moleküle in der Natur anschauen und überlegen, wo können wir diese sinnvoll modifizieren, sodass wir deren positive Eigenschaften erhöhen. In unserem Fall haben wir uns besonders auf die Zuckermoleküle fokussiert und haben ein Molekül hergestellt, was letztlich in der Impfstoffforschung Anwendung findet.
Professor Gilmer and my lab, the Max Planck Institute in Potsdam, have a long and ongoing collaboration in the area of the development of novel carbohydrate-based vaccines against infectious diseases. The innovative aspect that Professor Gilmore's lab brings to the table here is when he creates non-natural carbohydrates that contain fluorine molecules that make these carbohydrates more resistant to degradation in the human body and therefore potentially even more powerful in creating the next generation of carbohydrate-based vaccines. I've known Professor Gilmore for the past 16 years. And what stands out for me is his love for chemistry, his excitement to do basic research, his immense understanding of reactivity and function. But what sets him aside from many others is the fact that he's not just a great scientist, but he's also a wonderful person. He interacts well with the students and those who do research with him. And that is what makes him stand above in the chemistry community in Germany and well beyond.
Nicht nur ich, sondern auch meine ganzen Kollegen haben Rhein als jemand erlebt, mit dem man leidenschaftlich und lange über Chemie diskutieren kann. Jemand, mit dem man auch konstruktiv darüber reden kann, wie man seine Methodik anwenden kann, wie man sie verbessern kann. Es macht gelinde gesagt Spaß, mit ihm zusammenzuarbeiten.
What I can say is there's probably two sides to Ryan, and I mean this in a good way. There's the side that the scientific community sees, an incredible intellect who's really passionate about research and science. However, my personal experience, I would say that he's really supportive, really caring of his co-workers. If I was to pay him the highest compliment, I would say he's actually a role model for how I currently run my own research group.
Als Mensch und Person ist Ryan Gilmore eine sehr spannende Persönlichkeit. Zum einen ist er sehr ernsthaft in seiner Forschung. Zum anderen ist er unheimlich enthusiastisch, also wenn was funktioniert und neue Ideen dann, dann sprudelt das aus ihm heraus. Zum dritten ist er einfach furchtbar lustig. Also wir können auch sehr gut Spaß miteinander zu haben und das macht es eigentlich aus, dass wir so gerne zusammenarbeiten.